Esports is the idea of competitive players battling it out either in teams or individually, and they're competing for thousands of dollars of prize money. This can scale up from sort of $5,000-$10,000 right up to $1 million plus prize pool. It's an incredible industry, and it's actually something that's quite hidden from the general public.
ESL is the global leading company in esports. We do a lot of work with running tournaments online and offline and creating events around that. And most importantly, producing a huge amount of content for online streaming and productions for esports. ESL is over 20 years old now. Our headquarters still reside in Cologne, where it started, and it's now expanded out to over 15 offices around the world and studios.
It's the first time that the UK has seen an esports studio of this scale, and what we want to do is bring the best esports content to our audience.
So the type of productions that we do here at ESL UK range quite radically. We do smaller productions where it's literally just two people talking to the camera and then showing sports, which are esports. And then we do events within the studio itself, which will have a full audience, which will have people playing on the stage, which will have commentators, which will have analysts, which will have a really large production value. And having the ability to be able to switch between having a larger crew, which we require for those larger shows, and then being able to have a smaller crew for the smaller shows, but being able to maintain that level of control and quality is something that ROS enables us to do.
I think the most interesting thing for me looking at ROS from a new perspective is how it both caters to traditional broadcast, as we know, it's the large part of the market works with ROS. However, they can come in and they can completely understand our requirements from an esports perspective, which is something that is still very new.
One of the biggest challenges for us was not necessarily being able to have the same level of crew that you would have on a traditional broadcast shoot. So not necessarily having a single graphics operator, a single vision mixer, a single director, a single sound operator, that's a challenge in its own right. How do you go about doing that without necessarily reverting to automation, having that level of control that you would have from a manual production? And one of the things that we found when we moved over to using ROS was that we could have that level of control, that level of creativity that you would have on a larger production with less staff and without having to use automation. In our productions, we have a range of skill sets from our production operators. We have people who are technically adept and people who aren't so technically adept. One of the nice things about the Carbonite Flak desk, it enables operation on all levels. So if you need to use it in an advanced level, you can go ahead and do that. If you need to use it in a simple level, you can go ahead and do that. But the nice thing is it's very easy to transfer advanced operational procedures over to operators who don't necessarily know how to do that via dashboard. For us, dashboard is a very important part of the operation. Dashboard enables us to be able to do fairly complicated things, but not have to do complicated button pushes to do them. So we can have things like picture-in-picture on multiple games with multiple gamers at the same time, and just be able to record that with one single mouse click on dashboard. It's quite quick to program, very easy to do, and so something that an advanced vision mixer would do live, a not so advanced vision mixer can do just as easily with just a little bit of pre-production. Within dashboards, the ability to create custom panels gives us so much more power in operation. It enables us to integrate graphics system with our vision mixing desk, be able to recall graphics at the same time as recalling a macro. It enables us to do things that would require two or three operators to do normally with just one operator. So we can have the vision mix to cut at the same time a graphic is recalled, at the same time roll a VT, all happen at the same time simultaneously with one button click. We actually found that the dashboard was great because it didn't take long to make a dashboard, but we can create custom dashboards for each individual show. So rather than just have one panel that does one thing, we can have a panel for each individual show. And one of the other things that we use here at ESL UK is OpenGear. And OpenGear carries that tradition that we found with ROS, which is that interconnectivity via dashboard. So we can have a card within our OpenGear system, and that communicates automatically with Carbonite Black, with our graphics system, with our entire infrastructure through Dashboard. So we don't have to go ahead and spend hours and hours and hours programming a card that goes in. We know we can get a card for Open Gear, put it in, and it will work within our infrastructure fairly quickly. We use Expression for all sorts of things, for going from lower thirds to full screen graphics to dynamic graphics, which update literally on the fly. Expression for us has really been a game changer. Expression has all the features and functionality of really high-end graphic systems, but at a much lower price point and with the same flexibility and power, which has enabled us to have a really nice sheen to our productions. But there's one added bonus, because we've taken Expression across the company. Say, for example, in America, they produce Halo Show. They can send us a graphics file, literally over Dropbox or FTP, or however they want to send it to us. And that can work on our system, it can work in Poland's system, it can work in Germany's system. There's that interchangeability, which is really quite powerful, but also the integration within Dashboard as well. Just being able to send Dashboard files across the internet from each of our operations globally means that it's almost like we're not a global operation, almost like a micro village operation that's just spread across the world. There's always teething problems, but we found with Ross's support, a lot of those teething problems were made less horrible. One example is that we were having some unique problems with getting our Excel documents to communicate properly with Expression. That for us was a conundrum. We couldn't quite figure out how to do it. Ross, they remoted into our Expression machine, found the problem and fixed it for us remotely. For us, that was great to have. That level of support was amazing.
Ross was really interesting to ESL because we work with so much digital content that in the way of data feeds coming from the games, in terms of capturing digital footage and obviously creating a production around that. So what we were really looking for was an extremely flexible system in which we were able to harness the power of the graphics, overlays and content being brought in from the game itself into a live TV production. So when we were looking at the market, Ross really stood out as being a flexible and dynamic company in order for us to try and figure out the best solutions.